So, good morning. I did get some sun yesterday. I don't know if you can see. It was kind of hard for me to tell when I was vlogging yesterday about it in the sun, like when I was outside. But you can see it right here, little on my chin, and I actually did get burnt on my chest as well. Like when I got home on the dress, I was like, "Oh my God, your chest is all red." And it doesn't hurt as bad as it looks. So, it's not too bad, but anyway, I don't even know what to tell you. So today and yesterday, I don't think I mentioned this, but today even worse, I feel like I've been hit by a truck. I didn't have one drink at the wedding. Him and I, if I'm gonna have a drink, he will not drink so he can drive and vice versa. So he was drinking because he was part of the wedding party and they were taking shots for toasts and stuff like that. And so I was the DD. I didn't have one single drink. I drank a little bit of Coke and some iced tea from Bill Miller's. So it wasn't that, because that's actually what I feel like. Yesterday I felt hungover when I woke up, and I think it was just the lack of sleep for several days in a row, and well, the lack of sleep for the last 6 weeks. However, definitely the last couple of days, because lately we've been going to bed around 9 or 10 and then waking up, you know, getting a couple hours, then if she wakes up. But she's been doing good. She's almost sleeping through the night. Like if we feed her between 11 and 12, she's been sleeping to almost 6 in the morning. So to me, that's like almost sleeping through the night. It hasn't been bad at all. And Maddie, I've kept track of everything for Maddie, and I've kept track of everything for Autumn, and I'll have it in my mommy favorites video that I'm working on of how I keep track of everything, my favorite way to do it. But I'll always reference Maddie's like list of things that I had to kind of compare. Just, I know they're different babies, but just to kind of compare, you know, it's one of those things. No different than how I compare. You guys know Emmy's adopted. We didn't get her till she was 19 months, so I don't compare her to either one of the girls as a baby, because I was around her as a baby, you know, kind of. She was a family friend for a little while, so I have an idea of how she was as a baby, but not as like taking care of her. So I compare Maddie to Emmy as a toddler all the time. In her twos, you know, if I ever say, "Well, Maddie, Emmy didn't act like this. She was so easygoing," or "She potty trained easy," or, you know, whatever. I compare Maddie to Emmy like that, but I have no baby comparison other than to Maddie. So a lot of you guys wonder why I compare Autumn to Maddie and not to Emmy. That's why, because she was a year and a half when we got her. So, anywho, when Autumn becomes a toddler, I will have two children to compare her to. But I will go back and reference Maddie's list of stuff that I have for her, and, you know, like when she started upping her ounces and formula and different things like that. Now, Autumn does get breast milk on top of formula, so it's a little bit different. Maddie, after 4 weeks, got zero breast milk. She only got formula. So she's almost 7 weeks, and she's still getting breast milk, which is an accomplishment to me. She doesn't come to the breast as often as I would like her to, hardly ever, really, once a day if we're lucky. So she's just not latching like I'd like her to, but that's okay. You know, we've kind of done everything that we could do. But I am pumping, and she is getting breast milk that way. So when I go back and reference Maddie's stuff, it's one of those things, like I can kind of get an idea of her weight and how, because they're similar in shape and size, and food and diapers and just all things in general. What was I even talking about? How did I get here? Hashtag mom brain. I literally had to go back into the camera, watch a little bit of footage to even remember what I was talking about, how I got on a tangent about sleeping and eating and comparing babies, and I'm losing it. Anyway, I'm tired, you can tell. I was talking about the wedding. Andres had a few drinks, so I drove home, but because he had a few drinks, you guys watched in the vlog, he was a lot more outgoing. He danced a bit, so because he was dancing with me, we danced like almost the entire time. And I was wearing wedges, which heels and wedges they're not in my vocabulary much anymore. However, I was wearing a Forever 21, no, a Torrid dress that I got that was a little too long for me. It's just overall a little big, but I had to have it because it was on clearance. And it's a little too long, and without the wedges, I would have been stepping on it the whole night. So, yeah, because I was in the wedges, my whole body hurt because it was like dancing in platform heel type things. And so I woke up yesterday. Wait, when did we go to the wedding? Saturday? Yeah, oh no, so yesterday. Yeah, I woke up yesterday and I was super sore. I had blisters on my toes, like on the bottom of the pads of my toes. Bless you. And so, needless to say, I was miserable yesterday at the pumpkin patch as far as body wise. Like, I was just hurting and I didn't take anything for it. I wish I had. Today I feel a little bit better, but I'm still super sore. Like, my body hurts and my shoulders hurt, and I'm a little sore. So, and another thing I wanted to talk about is the reason I didn't go to the gym this past week. I kind of took a break after the 2 days that I worked out. I know. When I went to Zumba the Friday before last with Bia, during Zumba, like, I was jumping around and stuff, and I started to get a pain in my, what felt like my stomach, uterine area, like somewhere in my abdomen. I started to get a pain. So I told Bia, I was like, oh my gosh, I didn't realize I can't jump. Like, I figured I'm, you know, 5.5 weeks post-op, I'm good. No, that wasn't the case. I had that sharp pain all weekend and like into Monday and Tuesday of this last week. So I stopped. I'm not gonna be doing Zumba probably for a few more weeks until I build up some strength. And it could just be a number of things, you know. It could have been just a soreness in my belly. It could have been a bad complication. My, you know, abs, everything is stitched together. Now, my stitches should have already dissolved by now, but they, you know, there's a scar there. Could have just been, I don't even know what it could have been. I didn't go get it checked out, and I'm fine now. So I'm assuming that's what it was from. And I told Bia, you know, I wasn't concerned, because if the pain had continued, I would have gone to go get it checked out, but it did go away. And so I think when I go back to the gym now, I'm just going to walk, do the elliptical, strengthen my back and stuff like that. I'm not going to be jumping around. I love Zumba. Zumba is like the most fun to me when I work out, but I think I'm going to give it a few more weeks before I actually go do that. So anywho, I need to go to Dollar Tree. And I was just thinking about what I needed, and I can't remember for the life of me. I can't remember. I finally got my lights back on the desk, connected them again so that I could film. I have a sticker, Etsy sticker haul to film, and I need to do my plan with me for the week. I haven't decided if I'm gonna film that yet or not. It just depends, because Autumn's been laying here very silently for probably an hour and a half, and so I'm sure my silence is done. Like, I'm sure she's not going to hold on much longer for me to film two videos. So that's not going to happen, I'm sure. I also need to pump. And luckily we got the house kind of straightened up Saturday. Oh, something in my eye. So that's good. I do have a bunch of stuff that I've kind of been setting aside maternity-wise. And, like, things for her, like bottle warmers and bottles and just stuff that we haven't used that I really want to put on this yard sale website to sell. I just have a lot of, like, little things that I want to do today, and who knows, I may not get any of them done, but my goal is to get some things done at least. Autumn's having a cow, don't mind her. I'm gonna throw dinner in the crock pot real quick, because this is real life. She's having a cow, but dinner needs to go in the crock pot. So I'm using some chicken breast. This is probably about a pound, maybe 3/4 of a pound, but it's two large breasts, chicken breasts. So I'm gonna throw them in there with a packet of Italian seasoning and let that cook for about 4 hours or so.
It's a good learning experience.
So I spent the last hour and a half or so organizing my stickers. I originally was going to go with a large binder and kind of lay them out individually so I could see all of them, but I went ahead and went to 4 binders instead of 2. So I can pretty much see everything. And I filmed 2 sticker hauls. So let me know if you guys want to see, like, how I store. I mean, this is pretty typical for sticker storage, but let me know if you want to see how I store my stickers or, like, my sticker collection. Let me know that in the comments down below. But I was going to try and film. I was going to use this Boulder Bond kit and film a plan with me, but I think I'm just going to go ahead and plan and not even film a plan with me, because little Missy over here is getting anxious. She took like maybe a 45-minute nap, and I held her for a little while, and my back started to hurt, so I decided to put her in her rocker, but she's getting a little fussy, so I may have to do this later tonight when she actually goes down for bed. Okay, so my chicken is done. That looks good all by itself, but the recipe calls for half a block of cream cheese and a can of cream of mushroom, but I'm going to use cream of chicken and see how it tastes. And I'm going to, it actually calls for like bone-in chicken breasts, but I'm going to chop this kind of in half so the seasoning can kind of marinate throughout. I don't know, I'm making my own recipe. I will link the original recipe down below. We'll see how this comes out. And then I think I'm going to do like a side of mashed potatoes and a vegetable. So I'm about ready to pump, and I thought I would check on the chicken. I'm choking on almonds. Oh my gosh. Thought I would check on the chicken. It is so freaking good. OMG, you guys. What I did was I took the chicken out and I put it in my toaster oven just to keep it warm. But I didn't want it to cook anymore because I didn't want it to fall apart. It's already been in there for nearly 4 hours now, and it was already starting to like crumble when I picked it up, and I wanted it to be able, I have a lot of sauce. Like I should have probably had four to six large chicken breasts with as much as I ended up doing, because I ended up doing the whole block of cream cheese and a whole can of cream of chicken. If you hear the TV, it's, I'm watching this financial dominatrix on True Life. It's a weird show, but anyway, because I did a lot of extra sauce because I'm gonna make mashed potatoes and green beans with it, I only had two chicken breasts, and the chicken breasts are falling apart, and I didn't want it to shred or anything. I want to use like whole chicken breasts for dinner and kind of cut them into fours for each of us. So I'm just keeping them warm in the toaster oven, and this is the sauce. I ended up adding, like I said, one whole can of cream of chicken, 1 8-ounce block of cream cheese, and a whole bunch of seasonings. I threw in onion powder, garlic powder, Italian seasoning, salt, pepper, some seasoning salt, organic no salt seasoning, and I think I just threw in everything that I keep up there. All of my spices. I threw in a little bit of everything, and it is so good and creamy. I cannot wait to have this on mashed potatoes. Oh, so good. So now I'm gonna start boiling the potatoes. Andres is on his way home. He picked up Emmy for me. And yeah, I'm just gonna throw on some whole potatoes to boil. And I have a couple cans of green beans. I wish I had fresh green beans, because this would be amazing with fresh green beans. But hi, Mama. Hi. Do you have a good day? Woohoo! Good job.
I'm trying to present it again.
I don't even know. I didn't look. I'll look for you. So, it does smell good in here? So I'm gonna get this water boiling for potatoes and then pump. This may not look like a lot, but it is so freaking good. So good. Like I had it on that, staying warm in the toaster oven, and there was like a sliver of chicken that had fallen off. So good. I am so excited. And I got a little overzealous with the mashed potatoes. This is a 4-quart Pyrex. Mm-hmm. It's almost full. So we'll have mashed potatoes for days, but yeah. And then in the microwave, I have some green beans that I will be heating up, and that's gonna be dinner. There is the finished product. Chicken, mashed potatoes with some of the gravy on top, and green beans.
They're having green beans, chicken, and you know
they're
chicken.
Having, like good potatoes, and this new seasoning on the green beans is good.
Did you try the chicken?
Potato.
Did you try the chicken?
I did.
I'll try the chicken.
Is it delicious?
Mm-hmm. I'll try the chicken.
It's
not healthy. Oh, Lord.
It's really good.
Good.
Good night, tomorrow.
Good night, tomorrow.
Good night, tomorrow.
Good night, tomorrow.